Very good morning, everyone. Today, the topic which we are going to discuss is project evaluation. So, let's start with the topic. So, the project evaluation process uses systematic analysis to gather data and reveal the effectiveness and efficiency of your management. This crucial exercise keeps projects on track and informs stakeholders of the progress. So basically, project evaluation is a process where you cross-check your current actions and whether your current actions are as per the requirement of the project or not. So every aspect of a project is measured to determine if its proceedings are as planned, and if not, inform how project parts be improved. So basically, in project management, project evaluation, we cross-check that at the end of every week or day or whatsoever is your cross-checking time, that the project is going as per the planned procedure or not. And if it is not going as per the planned procedure, then what part has to be improved? What corrective measures one should take so that the whole process should go in a smooth way? Basically, you are asking the project a series of questions designed to discover what is working, what can be improved, and whether the project is in fact useful. So basically, here you ask questions to your own self that whether the project is going as per the need of the hour or not. So project evaluation can be broken down into three main types, which is pre-project evaluation, ongoing evaluation, and post-project evaluation. So now moving forward, we'll try to understand what are these three types of evaluations and why they are needed. So the first one is pre-project evaluation. So here you are pre-evaluating your project when you write your project charter to pitch to the stakeholders. So basically, this evaluation is needed when you are developing a business plan. Before going to the funders who are going to fund your project, you need to cross-check your each and every part so that when you go to the funder, if he has any question, you should be able to answer all the queries and you should not get stuck anywhere. You cannot effectively plan, staff, and control a new project if you have first not evaluated it. So it is very important that you should ask questions to your own self that whether all the aspects, all the areas of the project should be touched. Pre-project evaluation is the only sure way you can determine the effectiveness of the project before executing it. So it is a stage where you first at your own check the ifs and buts of the project and before executing it so that in future there should be no problems in the final execution. So the second type of project evaluation is ongoing evaluation. This type of evaluation is done to make sure your project is proceeding as planned and hitting all the scheduling and budget milestones as you said. So here you cross-check the current performance of the project with the targeted one and see that the cost and time is under check. So you should not cross the time limits and the money limits. So it is crucial that you are constantly monitoring and reporting on your work in real time. So you have to cross check your own self. See, it is a kind of self-retrospection that you are doing your best. You have to cross-check yourself at every point of time so that there should not be an external entity who will come and point a finger at you, so that you should be in a position to cross-check your own self, and if you find any deviation, you should take the corrective actions. Only by using metrics can you measure the success of your project and whether or not you are meeting the project goal and objective. So at every point of time, you have to cross-check that are you able to match the goals and objectives which you have already set in the pre-evaluation phase. So if you have done your pre-evaluation stage very nicely, then only your ongoing evaluation will be done. Because in pre-project evaluation, you have set certain targets for your own self. If those targets are realistic and achievable and up to your fuller utilization, your efficiency and effectiveness is completely utilized in your pre-project planning, then only your ongoing evaluation will go smoothly. So these two stages, in fact the three stages, are always interrelated to each other. If you have done your pre-project evaluation very sincerely, then only your ongoing evaluation will go smooth, because you have to match the targets which you have set in the stage one. So the third one is post-project evaluation. Think of this as a post-mortem. The post-project evaluation is when you go through the project's paperwork, interview the project team and principals, and analyze all relevant data so you can understand what worked and what went wrong. So basically, at the end of the project, when you think everything is complete, but at that point of time also things are not done, because here you have to find out where were the loopholes, where did you not perform as per the expectations, or maybe you have underperformed, or you could have done better. Maybe in the first stage, in the project evaluation stage, when maybe you should have set higher standards, but you didn't set good standards. So because of that, you did not perform as per your fuller capabilities. So here you have to find the loopholes in your stage 1 and stage 2. So project post-project evaluation is basically checking each and every aspect of your project. That where did you not perform well, maybe in the pre-project evaluation or maybe in ongoing evaluation. So only by developing this clear picture can you resolve issues in upcoming projects. So when here you are clear with your own mistakes, maybe your own drawbacks, then only in the coming projects you will be able to perform the best. So here we have studied three types of project evaluation: pre-project, ongoing, and post-project evaluation. So the purpose of these three project evaluation is, in pre-project evaluation, it is for setting good standards for getting funds from banks or any other source of finance. In ongoing, we continuously check ourselves that are we performing as per the standards. And in post-project evaluation, it is basically the future-oriented approach, where you see that whatever standards you have set are fine or not, have you performed as per the standards or not, where were the loopholes, what should be done in the next project. So it is futuristic in nature. So post-project evaluation is futuristic in nature. Now, moving forward, there are different steps in project evaluation process. The first step is So here, the process of post-project evaluation, the first step is evaluation soon after the completion of the project. We do this in two phases. The first is immediately after the completion of the project. So once you complete the project, the process of evaluation may include questioning yourself, like what has happened in actual, how do the actual stand as compared to the projected estimates. So is the actual output and the projected one, planned one, was same or not? What are the areas showing variances? Now you have to find out in which areas problems were there. What was the problem area? And what are the reasons for such variances? If you have found certain variances in terms of cost, time or quality, what are the reasons? And how much of it was unavoidable and how? So maybe there are certain variances which were unavoidable. So which areas were unavoidable? Because these problems you may face in future also. So you should be, maybe these areas are not avoidable, but you should be able to handle it so that the overall project should not suffer. And how many areas are avoidable? Like you could have avoided, but because of your own carelessness, maybe you could not. So you have to find both unavoidable and avoidable problems. So these are the things you have to look after immediately after the completion of the project. Then the next is you evaluate after some time, maybe about 2 years after the completion of the project. There are certain areas which you have to see. So what were these areas? Like whether the goal with regard to the technology envisaged is achieved. So like because, for example, you have launched a new technology, you cannot judge the performance of the technology immediately after its launch. It may take some time. So maybe after a year or two, you will check whether the new technology which you have launched has performed as per the expectations or not. So it has to be done over a period of time, not immediately. What are the reasons for shortfalls, if any, as evaluated in one, in the first point? The reason for shortfalls may include deficiency in plant layout, machineries installed, and the standards of input, etc. Maybe what are the reasons because of which the new technology has not performed as per your expectations? Maybe the quality of the technology is not as desired, or maybe you didn't cross-check with the customer, you didn't interact with the stakeholder in a proper way, and because of which the overall performance of the technology is not as expected. Then next is, what else could have been done to avoid the shortfalls? What extra measures you could have taken? So you have to identify what are the solutions. So that here we do not only focus upon the problem which we have faced, but we try to find out the solutions so that the next project could be a much better project. Then the last one is whether the market share as envisaged is in the project is being achieved. So have you captured your target market, or you were not able to capture the target market, and how you can do it? Maybe improve your advertising campaigns, or maybe your reach out to the customer is not that good. You have not focused upon the major needs of the customer, so you have to focus upon that. So you have basically, this is a solution oriented approach. The first phase immediately after the project was to find out the immediate loopholes, like why the project got delayed. And the second phase is to find out the performance of the project in the market. Then here we have the purpose of evaluation. Why do we need evaluation? It assists in determining the degree of achievement. Have you achieved the goals or not? So to find that, we need evaluation. It determines and identifies the problems associated. What were the problem areas and how we can improve it? It generates data that allows a cumulative learning. So it creates a database for the future projects so that we can have lessons learned
what lessons we have learned from the current project and what were the loopholes so that future projects will not face the similar problems. Then the last one is it assists in reformulation of objectives, policies, strategies in project or programs so that you can redefine your policies. Maybe the management policy which you have used is not effective. Maybe the leadership which you have done is not effective, was not effective. So the leadership can be improved. The current production style, capital intensive production style or labor intensive, you can change it if it is required. Maybe the strategies you have used, the vision was not clear to the employees, to the workers. So all those areas can be improved. The next is importance of project evaluation. So importance of project evaluation, the first is evaluate for technical skills. So when you implement a project, so what are you ultimately hoping for is that the candidates will have the technical skills to do their jobs. Resumes can be inaccurate and are not always to be trusted. So no matter how innovative your interview questions might be, people will come to expect it and learn about it before their interviews. So instead of these traditional methods, why not ask them to showcase their skills? So basically in evaluate for technical skills, you know that this is how a job should be done. So you can use project evaluation techniques to see whether when you are calling somebody for an interview, you know what are the key areas already, and you can hire people as per the skills which are required. So if it's a marketing position you are looking to fill, have your candidate show you how well they understand creating content of search engine optimization, writing blogs or something like that, Google Analytics. So you will have certain skill set. So and you will check your candidate on the basis of certain skills. So by proper project evaluation, you will get to know that these are the skills required to fill in this position. So accordingly, you will be able to hire a person who match the required skills. Second one is evaluate behavioral skills of the employees. So, you know, it is not always necessary that if a person is well skilled, then he will be able to perform the job, because behavioral aspects are very much important. Maybe the person has great knowledge, but his behavior, certain aspects of his behavior are very dominating, and he is not a team player, he is not a good leader. So when you have done project evaluation properly, you will know what behavioral aspects you are looking for in the next employees. The next is sign of leadership. What kind of leader you want? So leadership skills have to be checked. Every position requires good leadership skills. Even entry level positions required it in some cases. Although they will be doing more reporting to managers than anything else during projects, showing leadership in tasks, no matter how small, will be telling how they handle the bigger ones. So at any point of time, whenever you hire someone, they must have certain, you know, leadership skills. So leadership can be demonstrated in a group setting when there is a common goal. So you have to check that whether the person's personal goals are matching with the organization's goal, the project's goal. Then next one is cultural fit. So cultural fit, projects are not only great at evaluating candidates in real time, but will also give the candidate insight into the company culture and the types of projects they might be working upon. So, you know, what is company's culture? What company expect from the employee? Maybe there are certain companies who value employees a lot. They value loyalty a lot. So is the candidate which you are going to hire has remained loyal to the organization? You can, you know, understand this thing when you look at the CV of the person, if he has switched his job very frequently, it means his loyalty is very low. So accordingly, you can hire a person. Then the next one is mentorship opportunities. So here, not only do projects help develop candidates, but it also gives your department heads, hiring managers, and people in leadership roles the chance to become heavily involved in the process as mentors. So the managers are not only the one who get the work done, but they are mentors. They guide people to perform an activity. So they make them a mentor instead of a manager. In addition, mentors will be able to provide guidance and monitor candidate progress throughout the project. Mentoring prospective job candidates allow you to be at the forefront and actively involved to see these things from the beginning. So, you know, mentorship qualities can be nurtured. So, in any organization, these qualities has to be nurtured in the employees. The next is career growth. Your project should be able to help employees for their career growth. They should be able to learn something out of it. So these project by a proper project evaluation, it not only helps to satisfy the need of the organization, but it also enhances the personal skill set of the employee, and it will help the organization as well as the employees. So thank you very much.